Hello viewers, this is John. In this lesson, we are going to consider 10 different combinations and the approach to take to solve them. And I believe after watching this video, you should be able to develop the skill of solving combinations. Let's get started. Let's look at this position. And black plays 8-13. What we need to know is that the piece at 13 and then the piece at 22. When the piece at 13 and the piece at 22 are removed, we can take a shot to square 4. So 31 can move to king at 4. So if we draw the diamond diagram from our previous tutorial, I will explain the diamond diagram, how it works. If we draw the diamond diagram, as I have explained in that lesson, we see that the opponent piece on the vertex of the diagram should be removed. And then your piece on the diagram is what you use to take the shot. So 31 can take the shot to square 4. So what do we do? Now we need to remove the piece at 13. We have a piece at 24 that can do that job for us. And then for the black piece at 22, we also have a piece at 33 that can do the job for us. We play 24-19. So black take from 13 to 24. We also look at a situation where black will take from 14 to 23. In this case, black takes the piece at 19. So it takes from 13 to 24. So our next move is to play 27-21. So we play 27-21 to transport the piece at 16 to 27. Then we remove the piece at 22 as the diagram showed. So we remove that piece at 22 and then we take the shot to king at 4. Let's look at the other way around, where black take the white piece at 19 from 14 to 23. So if black takes this, then what we'll do is to transport a piece to 29. Well, we need black piece at 29, so we transport the piece at 16 to 29. Then we transport the piece at 22 to 33. And then black will take the piece at 17. So we take from 11 to 22. And then we take from 34 to 1. That's how we calculate the move in this particular situation. Let's look at the second situation. So in this game, black played 21-26. And usually, if there are spaces in these squares, it calls for king shots. So if you have pieces on these squares, it gives hints for shots or combinations. Now, what we need to do here is that since we have an empty square at 1, 12, and 24, we need black piece at 29. So if we draw the diamond diagram, let's draw the diamond diagram. You know, we can draw the diamond diagram. Now, the diagram, as we have explained from our previous lessons on the diamond diagram. So your piece on the diagram is what you are going to use to take the shot. So this piece at 43 can take the shot to square 1. So it can move from 43 to 32, 32 to 23, 23 to 12, 12 to 1, or 43 to 34, 34 to 23, 23 to 12, 12 to 1. We need a piece at 29, so we can transport the piece on this row to this row. So I've also covered a lesson on transporting pieces. You can watch that tutorial. So we can transport the piece from 16 to 29 by playing 27-21. We play 27-21, black takes, then we transport the piece at 19 to 28. We transport that piece and then we take the shot. We play 39-33. We take that shot and then 43 can then move to square 1. So that's how we take that shot. In this situation, black attacks the white piece at 17. So if you look at the situation very well, if we draw the diamond diagram, we see that the piece at 33 can take the short to the square at 2. So what do we do? The piece at 13 should be removed. As I said, the piece on the vertices of the diamond diagram should be removed. We remove this piece here. So how do you do that? First of all, we need to remove the piece at 19. So we can give out two pieces. White can play 28, 23, so that black would take the two pieces to 37. And then we have a free move because black has attacked the piece at 17. That gives us a free move. White can move to square 24, and then black will take to 21. Then we can remove the piece at 13. So after which white will play 38, 32, and then black takes to 28. Then the short is taken to square 2. So this is how it works. So we play 28, 23, black takes. We have a free move here because black will have to take the piece at 17. So we move to 24. And then black takes, then remove that piece at 13. We remove the piece at 13, and then we transport the piece at 37 to 28. Then the piece at 33 will now move to square 2. All right. Now, in this situation, black plays 14, 19. So 14, 19 is played by black. So again, if you look at the situation, if we draw the diamond diagram, if we draw the diamond diagram, we see that the piece at 43 can move to king at 3, so it can take the short at 3. So we need black piece at 30 and black piece at 39. So what do we do? We need to transport black piece to square 30, and then we transport the black piece to square 39 to take the short. So we play 29, 23. So black takes, and then black will take these three pieces to square 35. So we have a free move here, or a waiting move. This piece at 17 needs to be transported to square 39. So I've also shown this. If you draw the square diagram, the square diagram here shows that the piece at 17 can be transported to square 39. I've shown this in the video on transporting pieces. If you haven't watched that video, you can watch it so that you get a better understanding of how the pieces are transported. So the piece at 17 can be transported to square 29. Black is taking the white piece at 24. So we have a free move here. So the piece on square 32, we can either move it to 28 or 32. So in this case, we move to 28, and then black takes, and then we transport the piece at square 17 to 28. Again, we transport it to square 39. And then the short is taken. So 43 will take the short to king at square 3 or square 5. So in this situation, black plays 11, 17. We see that we have an empty square at 7 and then empty square at 9. So if we can remove the piece at 18, then we can take a short. So 40 can take the short to square 7. So if we draw the diamond diagram, so as we have learned, so we can go this way. So as we have learned, so the piece on the vertices on the diagram can take the short to square 7. So what do we do? We need to transport the piece to 34, and then we remove the piece on 18, on square 18. So we remove the piece at square 17. Then the piece at 18 is removed. Then we can transport the piece at 23 to 34. So by playing 33, 28, and then 43, 39. And then we take the short. In this situation, we see that we have an empty square at 12. Now, if we draw the diagram, we see that 32 can take the short to 12. But if 3 is removed, 32 can move to square 3. How do we remove the piece on square 3? By seeing this, we can also take a shot. Let me draw another diagram. We can take the shot with the piece at square 40. So 40 can move to 9. The piece at 40 can move to square 9 to remove the piece at 3. Then the shot can be taken to king. We have a king shot here. We remove the piece at 18. So as we have seen, so with the blue diamond diagram, the piece on the vertex of the blue diamond diagram should be removed. If you are able to remove this, and then remove the piece at 24, then we can take the shot to square 9 to remove the piece on square 3. Then we transport the piece at 36 to 27. Then we take the king shot. So this is how it goes. We play 27, 22. So remove the piece at 24. Then we take these shots. Then we remove the piece at 3. And then we transport the piece at 36 to 27. Then we take that shot. In this case, black plays 15, 20. We can remove the piece at 18. So when the piece at 18 is removed and transport the piece at 21 to 23, then we can take the shot to 27. So 40 can move to square 7. So we play 29, 23. Then we take and then transport the piece from 21 to 23. Then we take the shot. We play 34, 30. Then we take the shot to square 7. This is a complex shot. With this very one, black plays 20, 24, attacking the piece at 30. As black attacks the piece at square 30, we have an empty square at 13. So if we draw the diagram, so we see that the piece at 33 can take the shot to 24 and later removing the piece at 19. 19 will be removed and we see that we have an empty square at square 19 and already we have an empty square at square 10. Okay, so let's take the first part of this shot. This is a complex shot. We see that the piece at 33 can take the shot to 24. So we can take a shot to 24. What do we do? First of all, as black plays from 20 to 24, we need to play 38. So 38 need to be played. So we play 42, 38. We play 42, 38. So black will take. Now our next move is to protect the piece at 33 because 33 is what you are going to use to take the shot. So we play 44, 39. Then we transport the piece at 17 to 37 by playing 28, 22. And then we transport the piece at 37 to 28. Then we take the shot. Now, square 19 is now open. So what do we do? So black will take. And then we have a free move here. We'll play 34, 30. So we need to play 34, 30. With the square diagram, as I've said or I've explained, the square at 35 is surrounded by 30 and 40. So we move to square 30. So we move to square 30. And then the reason we are doing that is that the piece at square 4 will be transported to 15. We have a piece at 36. We can transport 36 to square 47. So we give black a king. And then we transport the king to square 20. Then we take the shot to square 3. Black has to take the piece at 27. Then we take the shot to square 10. Then black will take to 15. We transport the piece at 36 to 47. We give black a king. And then the king is transported to square 20. So we play 30, 25. And then white takes to square 3. Alright, in this situation, we see that 12 is empty, 3 is empty, 14 is empty. If you draw the diamond diagram, so we know that the piece at 41 can take the shots to the square at 5. You can take the short to the square at 5. So what do? We need to remove the piece at 27. So we remove the piece at 27 to allow the piece at 36 to move to 31 so that we can transport the piece at 26 to 37. Then the short can be taken. So first of all, we remove the piece at 28 and then 27 can now be removed. Then we transport the piece at 38 to 47 to give black a king. Then we play the stick move, so the king can now be transported to square 28. We play a stick move here. We have a majority capture. Black has to take these two pieces to square 35. And then we take to 33. And then black has to take with his king to square 28. Then we transport the piece at 26 to 37. And we take the short to square 5. Black plays 14, 20. And then we see there are empty squares at square 4 and 15. So if you draw the diagram, then we see that the piece at square 31 can take the short to square 4. So piece 31 can move to square 4. So what do? We need to remove the piece at 24 and then transport the piece to 29 and 28. So how do we do that? So the piece at 18 can be transported to 29. So we play 27, 29. Then we transport the piece at 17 to 28. And then we remove the piece at 24. And then we take the short. So we play 26, 21. And then we take the short to 4. So these are some of the strategies in the game. And then if you practice with this, you realize that with no time, you'll be able to solve very complex combinations in the game. And I hope this tutorial has helped you to understand how combinations work. Keep watching my videos. I have a lot of lessons to bring to you. Thank you.